You guys did good thinking of with another sort of video. It's not anime related, it's just as you can see before you, I've got the new 3DS. And you see I've got new Super Mario Bros. 2, I'm sure you can read, but I'll just point them out anyway. Zelda, Link Between Worlds, and Majora's Mask. I do go through phases of, playing these things. I recently got a 3DS XL, a new 3DS XL, which really disappointed me because you had like the original 3DS, which was that sort of metallic glossy look to it, so it was a fingerprint magnet. I know everything is a fingerprint magnet these days, but there's a way to limit that. And obviously it had the, what do you call it, the loose hinge that everybody complained about. I'm very precise with like the old 3D, the old DSs I used to have were obviously in immaculate condition because I keep everything in the best condition I can get. As soon as I get something new, I get a case or a whatever for it. I mean, I do have this kind of cheap ass case which I got from a cheap shop from for £1, but it does the job, keeps it still, keeps it dust free, keeps it protected. Anyway, I recently got rid of my 3DS XL, the new one, because of the reasons. I don't mind big screens, to be honest. I used to. But the thing that annoyed me was it does have the super stable 3D, which no matter where you're, as long as you're facing, if you see that little black dot beside the camera, that's the head tracker. A lot of things have got these days, especially phones. But like I was saying, whenever you're trying to move around, say you're playing, Majora's Mask, or you're playing Ocarina of Time, or any other game that requires the gyroscope, you need to move around like this, and you can feel the top screen like doing this. And I don't know, I just hate it. Nintendo says because they want to reduce the hinge cracking, but people are just stupid. Nintendo is stupid because people complain because they, like for instance, say this is the, I'm not gonna do this with my 3DS, no way. So say, oh, I'm gonna have a shot of my 3DS, and they go like this, they flip it open, and they go, right, I'm done, and they flip it shut. Instead of just closing it like you would normally do, just like, right, I'm done, and you just, that's you. Oh wait, I want to play my 3DS, open it up normal. That's the thing that bothers me. The thing is with these ones is the hinge is like 90% tight. There's a wee 10% give. And it does show you. Right, so you see if I push that, it just goes up just very slightly. That's me pushing really hard as well. It barely budges if you do this. You cannot feel it move at all. So if anybody has that same sort of problem as I do, that same sort of like, what the fuck, what's wrong with Nintendo? Get one of these. If you look at the new 3DS XL, the hinge part right there, if this damn phone will focus, like you can see that there, it's straight. Like this bit just right here, it's straight. But in the new 3DS XL, it kind of points up at an angle, so it doesn't catch anything. So that's why it's so loose, and plus it kind of slides back and forth like a typewriter. I thought my device was broke, or was going to break eventually. I took it back. One of the girls in the shop, she printed off a little statement for me for what Nintendo put, and that's the reason why they put it, because you got all these idiot kids that can't take care of their stuff and they just wreck everything. Anyway, it's just my small opinion on this. I do love the 3DS and I don't mind the big screen, because these screens are huge in my opinion. They're really, really big. But as you can see, I'll just do a little small overview. 3D screen, capacitive touchscreen, which sucks because I've got big thumbs and I've got big fingers, and you see, try to press like the bottom corner, the top right, whatever, even in the center, I hate it. I need to get my stylus out just to do it. You've got your analog slider just over there at the left. That's the smaller one, which you can see you can use in Majora's Mask to turn the camera, which is great because the control of the N64 was awful. To play as Zelda game, I honestly hate it. It's fine for everything else, like racing games and stuff like that, but to play a Zelda game, no. It's tolerable, but, you know. X, Y, B, A buttons, which are styled in the same as the Super Nintendo controller. Start and select. Home button in the middle there. There's a microphone, cartridge slot, headphone jack, stylus, power button, charging indicator, which will go orange, and yellow for the Wi-Fi. There's your volume slider and 3D slider. That's the worst thing about having a dog with black hair and having white devices. There's the camera, and as I pointed out before, that's a head tracking camera. Right speaker, left speaker, nothing on the back apart from the extra shoulder buttons. So you get ZL, ZR, R and L. Lanyard cable, charging port, infrared receiver, that's your two cameras for your 3D pictures, which they put 3D ability to take 3D pictures, yet the fucking cameras suck. VGA quality, not even a pixel yet. I mean, I know they could have slapped an extra 20, 30, 40 pounds onto the price, but if they gave you like a camera that was like say 8 megapixel, I think how amazing the 3D pictures would look if they were. Let's see, I've got New Super Mario Bros. 2, which I absolutely love. People say this game is way too easy to complete because it's all full of coins, and there's multiple ways to make coins, and you can get like 200-300 coins per level, things like that. Let's see how easy the game can be. I still think the game does get quite difficult. It's just a Mario game, you know. All Mario games get difficult, but the thing is, they say it's easy to, you know, finish the game because you get so many lives. It's not exactly easy to finish the game. It's easy to get lives, but it's hard to get a game over. That's the way I see it. You can still keep trying. You get a shit ton of lives to try. I mean, I'm up at like 150 lives so far, and I'm only in World 2. Still a fun game nonetheless. I don't really give a shit about anybody else's opinion. I like it. And moving on to A Link Between Worlds, which is the sequel to A Link to the Past. Even though it's a sequel, yet I don't know. Well, the game is really good. Like, you can do that, you can merge against the wall as a painting and move along. That's pretty sweet. You can visit all the old dungeons and stuff like that for A Link to the Past, which is my all-time favourite game, is A Link to the Past. And it's great that this is the sequel to it. They finally brought one out. And we have, last but not least, Zelda Majora's Mask 3D. Don't know why they added 3D in yet, but oh well. Because the game is already 3D. There we go. This is a great game. Really, really is. That's just my small opinion. You know, thanks for watching my video. I will see you guys in the next one, and I hope you enjoyed it. Adios.